there.
Oh, there's right in front.
Yeah.
Right in front.
It's a blue. It's a blue. Oh,
that angle is the best one yet. It's perfect.
If I want to talk about sea ice and climate change, I focus on polar bears. If I want to talk about the Great Bear Rainforest of British Columbia, I talk about spirit bears. You need that one iconic species to draw people into the conversation. If I want to say, let's protect the Sea of Cortez, you say, what is the most iconic animal in the Sea of Cortez? And it just happens to be the largest animal to have ever lived on this planet, and that's the mighty blue whale.
Because of their size, blue whales by far play the biggest role, protecting and preserving the entire planetary ecosystem. The ocean produces over half of the oxygen we breathe. A major reason why the ocean can do this is because of something called the whale pump. Whales produce nutrient-rich feces, which feeds phytoplankton, which feeds krill, which in turn the whales eat the krill. So basically, whales are the original farmers of the sea. Phytoplankton pulls a lot of carbon out of the atmosphere, so that is the part that helps sustain the environment and our whole atmosphere and everybody's ability to live on Earth. So the whales with this poop loop are basically creating a carbon sink.
Blue whales actually come to the places where they know that the upwelling is going to happen, and they poop these nutrients into the upwelling, a critical component in pulling us out of the mess of global climate change. And we're going to get it in the freezer.
My great area of interest with the endangered blue whale is the greatest threat that they face today. There are many threats that they face, but the greatest one is ship strikes. This particular threat of ship strikes hitting blue whales is avoidable, and this is the key to this species rebounding, recovering. For the greatest, iconic, largest animal that's ever lived on the planet, who helps enrich our oceans and fulfill our dreams to actually come back towards its pre-whaling numbers. We need their numbers to return because they have literally dropped from 350 to 400,000 pre-whaling to about 10,000 today. They're really on the edge as a species.
So the biosphere reserve we're creating is critical for the safety of the blue whales in Mexico.
Mexico is one of the most important countries in the world. It's one of the two or three or four hotspots for whale diversity and abundance.
Incredible. Wow. That was amazing. That was just absolute perfection.
To think that many of the blue whales that go out into the Pacific Ocean are born here in the Sea of Cortez. To see all of these mothers and their calves, these young calves who are gaining 200 pounds of weight a day as they drink their mother's incredibly rich milk that she's able to create because of the abundance of krill that exists here. It's just, that's the animal that's going to draw people into this conversation. Have seen dozens and dozens of blue whales, to have worked with scientists like Michael Fishback and Delphi Waters and to learn from them is just a wonderful opportunity to be value added to this journey. And then you come to Mexico and you realize that by protecting this, you're starting to create that corridor where these animals can recover and ultimately thrive and reach back towards historic numbers.